Hey there everyone, welcome to Back to Coding. Today we will be discussing about Firebase Cloud Messaging. So let's get started with our today's topic of discussion. Firebase Cloud Messaging is a cross-platform messaging solution that lets you reliably deliver messages at no cost. It means that you can deliver messages free of cost on any platform. It can be any platform such as iOS, Android, web applications, etc. Firebase Cloud Messaging FCM, formerly called GCM, that is Google Cloud Messaging, is a free cloud service from Google. FCM is provided by Firebase, a company acquired by Google in 2014. Using FCM, you can notify a client app that new email or other data is available to sync. You can send notification messages to drive user re-engagement and retention. FCM allows software developers to send push notifications for their applications to end users through an API. Push notifications are popular on mobile devices because they conserve battery life, unlike pull notifications, which continually poll the developer server for new information and can drain a device's battery life. Let's see what are push and pull notifications. Push notifications, also called server push notification, is the delivery of information from a software application to a computer device without a specific request from the client. In simple terms, it means that push notifications originate from a server. Typically, the end user must opt in to receive alerts. Opt-in usually takes place during the install process, and end users are provided with a way to manage alerts if they change their minds later on. Then an important advantage of push notifications in mobile computing is that the technology doesn't require specific applications on a mobile device to be open in order for a message to be received. This allows a smartphone to receive and display social media or text message alerts even when the device's screen is locked and the social media application that is pushing the notification is closed. Now let's check what are pull notifications. Pull notifications are updates delivered to a computer or mobile device in response to a user or software-initiated pull of a remote server. In simple terms, pull technology refers to clients that make requests to servers. This is the traditional way to structure a client-server architecture. Now you might be wondering, what is pulling? Well, pulling is the continuous checking of other programs or devices by one program or device to see what state they are in. Usually to see whether they are still connected or want to communicate. Again, in simple terms, pulling is when a client continually asks a server if updates are available. Generally, pull notifications are non-critical updates. It's the more traditional approach in which a user or software client makes the initial request for information. Now let's see what's the difference between two of them. In pull technology, client requests information from a server, whereas in push technology, a server initiates information updates to a client. An example of pull technology is a web browser requesting a web page, whereas in push technology, it's an email server transmitting an email to an email client. With FCM, developers can send three types of messages: notification messages, data messages, and both notification and data payload. Notification messages are displayed on the user's device by FCM on behalf of the application. They are handled by the Firebase SDK itself. Typically, a notification message contains title, message, icon, etc. These messages can be sent from Firebase console UI. The notification will be shown automatically when the app is in the background. In order to send a notification message, you need to use notification key in JSON data. For example, here is the key. The body is subscribed to Back to Coding right now to get such amazing contents. Notifications and title is just subscribe now. Data messages are directly processed by an application which is responsible for delivering the message to the user. They are handled by the Android app. You can add these kind of messages if you want to send some additional data along with the notification. But sending these messages through Firebase console is not possible. You need to have a server-side logic to send the notification using Firebase API. You need to use data key when sending this message. Now let's see an example of data message JSON. The to field contains the data key and it has a data message. Let's see the third type, which is messages with both notification and data payload. First, let's see what is payload. When data is sent over the internet, each unit transmitted includes both header information and the actual data being sent. The header identifies the source and destination of the packet, while the actual data is referred to as the payload. A message can also contain both notification and data payload. When these kinds of messages are sent, it will be handled in the two scenarios depending upon app state, background or foreground. For these messages, we can use both notification and data keys. When the app is in background, apps receive the notification payload in the notification tray and only handle the data payload when the user taps on the notification. When the app is in foreground, app receives a message object with both payloads available. An example of notification and data payload message will be, it contains two part, body part, title, icon, and the data part contains channel, URL, and message. In FCM, there is also a concept known as message targeting. Messages to applications can be delivered in three ways: to single device, to group of devices, to devices subscribed to topics. Developers have the option to create messages in the notification composer, which can send targeted messages to specific segments of users. These messages are fully integrated with Firebase Analytics, which tracks user engagement. Let's see the first step: sending to single user. When a single user is targeted, the Firebase registration ID is used to identify the device. The registration ID has to be mentioned in the field of JSON. Two part, data, message part. Topic messaging. Topic messaging is useful when a segment of users is targeted for messaging. For this, all the users have to subscribe to the Firebase topic. For example, when you want to send messages to all the users who are engaged with news, you can create a topic named news and send notification to news topic. The request format of topic message is given below. In the to field, you need to mention the topic name. Data, message. That's it for this tutorial. I hope this video has helped you as a basic introduction to FCM. Thanks for watching, and do like, share, and subscribe to my channel.